April 30, Tuesday of the second week of Easter. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to Nicodemus, "You must be born from above. The wind blows where it wills, and you can hear the sound it makes, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit." Nicodemus answered and said to him, "How can this happen?" Jesus answered and said to him, "You are the teacher of Israel, and you do not understand this? Amen, amen, I say to you. We speak of what we know, and we testify to what we have seen. But you people do not accept our testimony. If I tell you about earthly things and you do not believe, how will you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has gone up to heaven except the one who has come down from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so must be the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life." The Gospel of the Lord. The Son of Man must be lifted up. This early in John, Jesus already talks about his death in Jerusalem or his ascension into heaven. The Son of Man is Jesus himself. The title has an apocalyptic connotation. The book of Daniel speaks of the Son of Man coming down from the clouds. As he continues to speak with Nicodemus about the things that are above, Jesus deepens their conversation. He has all the right to do this because he comes down from heaven. He knows what he is saying. Time will come when he will be lifted up like the bronze serpent in the desert during the time of Moses to give life to those bitten by the fiery serpents. Nicodemus can only guess how eternal life looks like. That lifting up is also mind-boggling for him. Nicodemus is found wanting when trying to understand Jesus' meaning of being born from above. He does not yet possess the Spirit, which blows where it wills. Even if he is a distinguished teacher of Israel and trained to interpret the Scriptures, the story does not tell if Nicodemus comes to believe in Jesus. We presume that Jesus is able to convince him, who seems open to divine teaching. We can lift our hearts and minds to God as long as we are open to Jesus.